Jay Shrek, Myths, Legends, and Lies. You know, we went to a special place today, Black Mesa Ruins. And, you know, a lot of people talk about hidden ruins and things like that. But the reality of it was, you know, I just stumbled into it on the internet. And then I saw a book that said, you know, ruins that most people don't see. And, you know, I've driven by this location probably 100 times, easily 100 times. And it's only 3/4 of a mile off the road. But the reality of it is that three quarters of a mile is straight up. You know, what we found out was that HOHOKAM people were there between 800 and 1100. The walls on the backside are spectacular. It is one of the most awesome places we've ever got to. You know, those walls are 13 feet tall easily, and the construction is unbelievable. And when you think how old they are. But, you know, all we did was Google Arizona Indian ruins. So how do you do the work to try to find this cool stuff? You know, one thing we found out too was I'd seen two drone pictures of this, people had droned it, and I saw some pictures, but I've never seen a video on this location. And I'm not saying this is the only one. I'm not going to say that, but we could not find one video on the ground of somebody up there other than still pictures. And so it was exciting for us to be able to go up there and kind of feel like we were going to be the first people that got to document this. There's a lot of shards on the ground. There's some really neat petroglyphs on the backside. It's a spectacular place. Now, the only thing to remember is this before we get into this is that it's straight up and there are no trails, none. You might stumble here and there on a game trail, but it's going to be straight up. Now, it took us about an hour to get up there, and it took us about 30 minutes to get down. And I tell you, it is straight up. But when you get up there, you're going to see something that the average person's not going to get to see. And now, if you can't hike that, that's why we made this video. You know, so you could take a look and see what this is. Some of the most spectacular walls I have ever seen on ruins, and ruins are our thing. So we were completely stoked and excited, and I hope you enjoy this. And if you do hike it, remember, there's no trails. So me and James went the southern route. I went the northern route when we split. I think the northern route was easier. And then we took the backside around south down, which took us about 30 minutes, but still a rugged hike. So be prepared, take lots of water, and please make sure that you leave the ruins as you found them. Jay Shrek and James, Myths, Legends, and Lies, Black Mesa, and it was awesome. Hey, Jay Shrek.
And James.
You know, we're looking for Black Mesa today. And there's two ways to do this. There is, as you look at the avoid overheating sign, I know there's a part, this parking lot's here. I think there's another parking lot we're gonna hike up to, but there's a lot more room down here. So I decided that we would just hike up that. Now, the funny thing about Black Mesa is, how did I find Black Mesa? How did I find Black Mesa, James?
The internets.
All I did was look in there, Googled it, and guess what? It came up. There's also a book on this, so this is not secret. I passed this thing 100 times, I'm sure. What about you, James?
Yeah, actually, hikearizona.com literally tells you, hey, this is the ruins you've passed 100 times.
Hike Arizona has got every trail to everywhere, which James found. I wasn't really aware of them. So when you think you got double secret stuff in the state of Arizona, here's the thing. There's only a few rare things that are secret in the state of Arizona. Agree with me, James?
Yeah, pretty much someone's found it and documented it.
Now, I saw a drone shot of this where he was either here or down there to that next stop. And what it appears is that rock ledge up there is actually not natural. That's a man-made wall. So that's what I'm expecting. And so I thought there's two ways to get up to Black Mesa. Either come up over this ridge
or go down through this valley, which it looks like there's a Jeep trail that runs you north, and then you can swing back over, which would probably be easier, or bushwhack up the hill. Now, the good news is it's only 3/4 of a mile, right?
Yeah, it should be a short hike.
This is supposed to have walls that are some of the biggest walls in the state of Arizona, up to 13 feet. Now, again, this is all over the internet. How do you find this stuff? We Googled it.
Google, research.
This is actually in a book also that's been published. So there's all kinds of stuff like this. Only thing we ever ask is be responsible when you go to the places, but there's no secrets in the state of Arizona. Well, maybe one or two, but not a hell of a lot. So let's get our stuff, let's pack it up there, let's head up this hill, and let's start this adventure. What time is it, James? I want to know how long this...
10 o'clock,
but okay. It's 10:30 by my watch.
10:30.
So we'll find out exactly when we get to the top how tough it was, and we'll see what kind of adventure we can get in today. So hell, let's go.
Let's go.
Now, you know, one thing we always do is I always got a survival box of some type, right? So what we do is make sure that we've got, you know, I got plenty of water. I'm gonna take 4 bottles, even though this is not a very strenuous hike. I'm just gonna make sure I don't run out of water. And that's important to me. And so I always have water on me. And I don't care if it's winter. I'm going to have water on me.
I laugh how he carries it, but...
This is how I feel good. Works my legs out too,
yeah,
James.
Yeah. A little thing else to note. We always have like an extra pair of shoes. We got extra
clothes. Pair of shorts. Because I've ripped them out before too.
You'll always notice on camera, I have my survival pack. That's got a little bit of everything you could possibly need to run into stuff. I like mine heavily organized. Here's our emergency flag if we get stuck somewhere. I have an extra cotton bandana. We got a rain jacket because, as you can see, the weather is not your typical Arizona weather today. And we got some extra food. So those are all things we try to keep in mind when we head out on the trail.
So let's pack that shit up and go.
Let's go.
So we're taking a walk by the side of the road. You know, what do you expect to see up there today, James?
We're supposed to be looking for some really nice walls still intact. And a pretty good example of some older ruins that get kind of overlooked out in this way.
You know, what intrigued me was they said that the walls were 13 feet, which would make them some of the biggest walls of any ruins around. So what we're doing right now is if you take a look down here to the road, show that down there, James, there's all the traffic right on 17. We came through the fence, and now it's just a matter of picking where we want to bushwhack to get to where we want to go. So there's no trails other than game trails that I've seen. How about you?
No, I mean, it looks like we're on something that parallels the road, the Jeep road. Our general goal is to get up, and we want to get to the left side of this ravine here, and then that way we can make a clean approach up.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Here's the last guy that probably didn't make it, right? So what we've got is two options if you look down. Jeep road coming up, going across, and then I believe they're right there. There's the southern tip, right? That would be about 3/4 of a mile. You got a ravine that runs down the middle, and then we could either take that up, or we ought to be able to take this up. But we'll just have to get up there and see, though. I mean, that's...
Well, that's the fun part of this, yeah.
We're gonna have to go right. We're gonna have to run that ridge regardless. Man, we're climbing fast. I mean, let's go, we're getting up there fast. A little burn. A little burn, James.
Yeah, you're feeling it, huh?
Tell you what, I came down with a plantar fasciitis, and I'm telling you what, it is brutal. And you know, everybody I've talked to, has had it. You know, we were training to do a 100-mile deal and took me out completely. So I've been out of this. I haven't been able to hike, and that's all we do is hike. And I've been able to hike, I'll put it that way, because we muscle through it. But man, it hurts. Feel like somebody hit your foot with a hammer. Anybody out there's had it, leave a comment. Tell me what you did to get over it, because this shit's kicking my ass, even though James.
Well, we got our breath. We're going to move on up. See what we find. We got to go way up there.
Yeah.
But we'll get there.
A little engine that could, right?
What we call Jay Shrek.
He used to call me Billy Goat in the day. Billy Goat is old goat now. Or I got your goat. Or coming down will be good though. So that does look like a rock wall.
Now this is the point where me and James split. Now he went to the right, which would take you right around the point, and you're right underneath the ruins. As you can see, he's pretty vertical at this point right here. I went left, and even though it was fairly vertical, I cut through some paths, and it actually ended up being a little better. So if you go straight up, I went to the left, he went to the right, and we both made it. And it's what a spectacular view from the top.
This is pretty spectacular, James.
That's pretty cool, man. That's a big structure. They stacked a lot of rocks.
You know, and the funny thing is, you drive by here and you see this all the time. That wall is unbelievable. And they haven't done anything up here. This is original. Oh man, ah! This is probably, I'm going to say, the most impressive natural ruin I've seen. That's, you know, not out where everybody can get to it. This is unbelievable.
Yeah, this is crazy, man. You think about how much time it took to stack all these rocks. This is like a 4-foot thick wall.
Well, I mean, let's just say, just to be safe, let's say it's 1450. You know, it's in that era.
I would think, yeah, man.
Look at the construction of the walls right there. Look how, look, they use those smaller rocks in there. That is really cool. I tell you, these ruins and these walls, I mean, you look at the build on these walls, and the size and the stacking, it almost looks like they built in two sections. This original section right through here, and then it almost looks the way they manufactured, you know, and you know there was a complex system in their stacking. You know, this just wasn't half-ass. They had a system of how they placed each rock and how they leveled it, and you can almost see that this wall is built into two sections. Because this lower wall, the first section of the wall, has kind of fallen down, but the original back section, which I want to really get a good picture of, is the backside, which shows how really massive this structure is. I mean, when you look around here and see also the amount of small rocks that they use to fill. But, I mean, this is our culture to a certain degree. We still, you know, even though this wasn't our ancestors per se, I can imagine these people living up here and how spectacular this really was for an hour hike. It was definitely worth it. You know, I saw drones, but I saw very few people come up here. So this is one that I have not seen people come to. But look out there. Well, I can honestly say that Black Mesa was definitely a bucket list hike. And how gorgeous was this? This is really spectacular. No trash. One thing, I know that sounds funny to a lot of people, but no trash, no graffiti, you know, total respect. How neat is this? I tell you, it wasn't an easy hike, even though it was only an hour, but it was totally spectacular. And there's 17. Take a look at 17. How's your shots?
Pretty good. I got off the
There's a Sonoran desert tortoise.
There's a little desert tortoise right here. Hello, guy. It's amazing to me that they get up here and they even operate, right? We're hanging outside the cliff and there's a desert tortoise on the top. I haven't seen one of them forever.
Yeah, me neither. That's what caught my eye.
Well,
that's cool find.
That is the cool find, James.
Take it easy, buddy.
You know, they do have signs, so they have excavated this, and archaeologists have come up, and I'm sure they've taken, all the pottery and things like that out of here, which is good. There's no reason for it to be here. But make sure you take care of it. I mean, that's one thing that me and James stress is enjoy this. Go do it. Go find it. Go see it. You know, it's not a secret. But, you know, when you do find it, respect it. You know, respect the area. Respect the fact that, you know, again, one of the things that I think about is if I was up here, what was it like, you know, let's just say 1450, you know, what was this land like, you know? I'll bet the cars they saw on the highway are a lot older. That was a joke, James, now. Okay, that's bullshit. You didn't laugh, okay? But it's pretty spectacular to think that, you know what? And again, why were they up here? To protect themselves, right? That's why they're always up here. And this is only one. I'm going to say up here, and I'm going to guesstimate this, and this is a guesstimate. I'm going to guess up in this area, there's 20 ruins. Up to 20 ruins in this area alone. And if you crest it across and you think about it geography wise and you shoot across, now you also think about that there's ruins all the way across this band over Lake Pleasant and all the way through here. And there are ruins all over. And if you've got a big mountain, a flat mesa, you probably got ruins. So just think about that when you're thinking about secret ruins. I know there's five sets of ruins on this side also. So they're everywhere. Just take care of them when you find them and protect them. And secrecy is not protection necessarily. Now, if the site has not been dug, then it's a secret. And if a site's not been dug and you find a site, get a hold of archaeologists, get a hold of the state, get a hold of some of the Indian tribes, and let them know if you would happen to find a place like that. Because eventually it's going to get found, and eventually somebody's going to steal the stuff out of it. So that's how you protect this, not by trying to be secret. Because if you don't tell anybody, and they leave that stuff in there, or you steal it, that's not being responsible. Okay, look at this. Tell me this wall here isn't spectacular. Look at this thing. This is massive. You know, I didn't see this on the other side, and I knew the walls were fairly tall from the inside, but you get back out here and look at this. This is unbelievable. I mean, unbelievable. And look at all the shards that other people have collected and put down here. James saw those. Okay, so look at these shards. Now, one thing that we see on these shards, and James made the same comment, is very primitive, you know, and there's no art on them. So that also tells you basically this is a pretty primitive and old site when you look at shards that are this basic. So, I mean, this is really a pretty cool deal to see those shards. But I tell you what, after going to Holbrook, I mean, I'm kind of a little bit shard snobby because there's millions of shards down there. So when you just see a few up here, it isn't nearly as big a deal as then when you go to Holbrook. Look at this wall. I can't get over this. This wall is ridiculous. Now, this is unbelievable. This is spectacular. This is why I do this right here. Man, look at this. Look at this wall hanging off here. Don't let me fall off the cliff, James.
Yeah, don't fall.
Okay, now what I'm looking for myself is petroglyphs.
Yeah, I haven't seen any in this area.
Look at this wall rounded off. This is art. This is art right here. And this wall held. It stayed strong. This outer wall is perfect, just as they built it.
Yeah, it's really impressive that it has not leaned. It has not, you know, seemed to have disfigured at all. That's the first thing I noticed coming up. I was like, is this thing going to fall on me? And then I realized how sturdy it looked.
This is why we do this, James, isn't it?
Yeah, no, this is definitely one of those moments where you're just kind of awestruck.
I'm sitting in front of this wall, and I've never seen a picture of anybody sitting in front of this wall. It doesn't mean they haven't, but I've seen it. I've seen no one sitting in front of this wall, and I kind of feel like a little bit of a pioneer, James, you know?
Yeah, this is a good one, man. I'm glad we came up here today. We picked, like, the perfect weather, man. It's been real hot all summer, and today it's in the, like, low 80s. A little humid for our taste of desert rats, but definitely a nice change from hiking in 108.
Well, this is I'm awestruck here. You know, I really am. I am totally awestruck. This is just so impressive on this side. It's impressive on the other side too, so don't get me wrong, but this wall is spectacular. It's unbelievable. I'm so excited. Who would have thought I'd be so excited, James, about a rock wall? I mean, I built rock walls. I understand the work. And I understand but the skill set that this wall would be here after, let's just say 900 years, for example, 600 to 900 years. You know, what gets built 600 to 900 years? And look at that, there's no air holes, there's no nothing. This wall is solid. And you know, and every stone was put there by somebody. You know, so the labor it took to build this wall and the work, and how much work it took them to put this wall together, and then not to miss that you're sitting on this top of this hill. I mean, unbelievable. It's absolutely unbelievable. Well, I'm wondering, you know, why I'm up here, James. I'm wondering if that's our best journey down.
That's what I was gonna do, man.
It shook a lot easier coming down there and then backside this ridge. I tell you, these ruins and these walls, I mean, you look at the build on these walls and the size and the stacking, it almost looks like they built in two sections. This original section right through here, and then it almost looks the way they manufactured, you know, and you know there was a complex system in their stacking. You know, this just wasn't half-ass. They had a system of how they placed each rock and how they leveled it. And you can almost see that this wall is built into two sections, because this lower wall, the first section of the wall, has kind of fallen down. But the original back section, which I want to really get a good picture of, is the backside, which shows how really massive this structure is. I mean, when you look around here and see also the amount of small rocks that they use to fill each and every one of these, is pretty incredible. You know, you look at some of these rocks like this that somebody, an ancient, put in there, and I want to put it back. But I mean, it just is amazing how these walls and these small rocks were in there to level each section out to make sure that you continue to layer to be able to build a 14, 15, 16 foot wall. I mean, I don't know if I've seen walls this spectacular. (sighs) Well, this isn't a super Indiana Jones moment, but it is an Indiana Jones moment, isn't it?
Absolutely, man. We have yet to stumble upon stacked rocks that have lasted this long, this tall, and like massive.
I can honestly say, though, I think this is going to be the first video I've seen where actually somebody came up and videoed it. I've seen pictures, and I've seen a couple drones, but I've yet to see anyone shoot this Black Mesa ruins. So I guess that's a little bit of our Indiana Jones moments. But what a beautiful place. What spectacular. Let's go around to that other wall. Okay, look at this. Tell me this wall here isn't spectacular. Look at this thing. This is massive. You know, I didn't see this on the other side, and I knew the walls were fairly tall from the inside, but you get back out here and look at this. This is unbelievable. I mean, unbelievable. And look at all the shards that other people have collected and put down here. James saw those. Okay, so look at these shards. Now, one thing that we see on these shards, and James made the same comment, is very primitive. You know, and there's no art on them. So that also tells you basically this is a pretty primitive and old site when you look at shards that are this basic. So, I mean, this is really a pretty cool deal to see those shards. But I tell you what, after going to Holbrook, I mean, I'm kind of a little bit shard snobby, because there's millions of shards down there. So when you just see a few up here, it isn't nearly as big a deal than when you go to Holbrook. Look at this wall. I can't get over this. This wall is ridiculous. Now, this is unbelievable. This is spectacular. This is why I do this, right here. Get me through here, James, if you're not. Oh, you're so sweet. Man, look at this. Look at this wall hanging off here. Don't let me fall off the cliff, James.
Yeah, don't fall.
Okay, now what I'm looking for myself is petroglyphs.
Yeah, I haven't seen any in this area.
Look at this wall rounded off. This is art. This is art right here. And this wall held. It stayed strong. This outer wall is perfect, just as they built it.
Yeah, it's really impressive that it has not leaned, it has not, you know, seemed to have disfigured at all. The first thing I noticed coming up was like, is this thing gonna fall on me? And then I realized how sturdy it looked.
Can you give me some shots on this, like this?
That's what I'm doing.
You sound aggravated, James.
No. I'm just making sure I don't slip. I wanted to make sure.
You want to watch out for these rocks, but climb along this place. Oh, looky there. What's this one? There's a lizard. It's because I want you to see this eagle.
You know, it's hard to pass this stuff up. You always want to see every inch of the place when you get up here.
Well, would you come back? Yeah, I would. Would you?
Yeah, heck yeah, man. I'd do it just for that climb, to be honest.
Well, you know, I think the both ways we did it were the wrong ways. So we're going to try a new way down, and we're going to see how that works.
The top is really beautiful though, with the grass.
Yeah.
It's like walking into another world. It just stretches on and then goes on to the next mesa top. It's really cool.
Damn. You see a petroglyph? Is that what you see?
You're a desert tortoise.
Okay.
There's a Sonoran desert tortoise.
Here's a little terror of the desert tortoise right here. Hello, guy. It's amazing to me that they get up here and they can even operate, right? We're hanging outside the cliff and there's a desert tortoise on the top. I haven't seen one of them forever.
Yeah, me neither. That's what caught my eye.
Wow.
That's cool vibe.
That is the cool vibe, James.
Take it easy, buddy. Be well.
Well, the good news is, one of the easiest ways to know that you're at the right spot is when you see this sign that says, avoid overheating, turn off air conditioner, next 5 miles. Now, the first thing I'm going to tell you about that sign is this. I ain't turning my air conditioner off if it's a million degrees out. And then second thing I'm going to tell you is that is the road that you come in on. When you see that sign, there's really a nice parking area. Now, we're right on the highway, but the nice thing is if you do decide to go to that next turnout up here, there's not a lot of room and it's not easy to get on. And I felt like the truck was pretty secure here because you can park it out of the way and people can't see it. And then you can walk along the guardrail and get to the trail. Me and James went up that way, basically went up that ridge right there. We came back the back way. I wouldn't want to go up that way, even though that got extremely steep. When you get to the very top up there, you can see that's almost putting your hand down. Now, we had an advantage of the water. It had rained, the ground was moist, I was getting some really good traction, so I never felt like I was going to slip. If you climb this way, you agree, James? I mean, the rocks were loose. It would have been a lot.
When it's dry, you wouldn't want to go that
right,
way.
Right.
I mean, that was definitely an easier approach.
So there's the ancient ruins that you can see right there that you don't even know exist, right? How crazy is that? That's why I got to say I love Arizona. Let's go home.
Let's get home. Nice little day trip for sure.
Around. But that was a good trip. I mean, that was, so would everybody want to go on that trip? You'd have to be a pretty good hiker, right?
Yeah.
And not be afraid to get, you're going to get stuck. You know,
yeah, you're going to be expecting to go off trip.
Yeah, you're going to get scratched. There's no, we saw maybe about 40, 50 yards of trail that was a game trail.
Yeah.
Coming down that backside, that was really it.
Yep.
Other than that, there was no trail. It was total trailblazing. And no trespassing signs. There was a sign up there that said archaeology dig, enjoy, but don't take anything or don't dig. And other than that, that was pretty impressive.
Yeah, that's a spectacular sight, man. Really great petroglyphs. All around good experience.
Oh, that was a great time. That was a great one. I felt like we were back. We hadn't been out in it for a while. I felt like, you know, with my foot being jacked up, I felt like hadn't been out in it, right?
Yeah.
And today we got it back out in it. That's what nice was. And you know, hell, we're already getting ready to go back into town, and we didn't blow a day. We spent a lot of time up there, and
not even 2 o'clock.
Yeah, that's awesome. So yeah.
Off we go.
Let's go home.